Hey guys, I'm back in Maine today, this time at a different treehouse called the Cliff House. I showcased the same owner's two other treehouses, the Canopy Treehouse last year and the Skyframe more recently. So be sure to go and check out those two other treehouse tours as soon as you're done with this guy. But right now I'm looking out towards the lake. I'm next to a fire pit. You've got a hot tub and a gorgeous interior. So definitely a lot to cover on this tour. Let's now go and hop right into it. Welcome to the Cliff House at Purposely Lost. This is the back exterior of the home that you're going to see when you first pull up in your car. And from this bird's eye view from the drone, you can kind of see the size of the clearing and all the space you have here deep in the woods. We'll now head briefly underneath the structure to point out a few things. You have this nice picnic table for some outdoor dining, and there's also this tall tree that goes straight through the home. This is the main outdoor area. Of course, the highlight is this huge hot tub. Also, later at night, there are some string lights you can turn on, and the tub is perfectly positioned in front of the home. Right next to the hot tub, you then have this sweet fire pit set up with enough seating for at least four people. This is the view from deep in the woods looking back at your Airbnb. If we now pan up, you have a bunch of exterior lights that you could turn on later in the day, which really help to brighten up this property. There's also a ton of really cool windows, definitely a custom window job, I think, because there's some very interesting shapes and dimensions. Let's now quickly venture down this path because it leads to the lake. You have these two boats all to yourself and then this dock, which is completely private just to you. It is not shared with any other Airbnb guest or local, so you can do all of the swimming or fishing throughout your stay that you desire. If we zoom out a bit, you can see there's not another soul in sight. It gets even better later in the day with sunset. I have not showcased too many Airbnbs lately that have private waterfront access. But that's it for everything outside, so let's now begin to go and check out the interior. The first section is actually a screened-in porch. You have this comfortable lounge area. You'll notice that tree that goes straight through this part of the home. On the opposite end, you have this nice dining table, so another option for you to eat outside. Now we'll go to the actual enclosed interior, so I'll walk through this door and come inside. The first space to highlight is this dining and sitting area on the left, but before we go any further, I'll hit just one button to turn on this electric fireplace. It's very easy to use, feels cozy, and warms up the area quickly. After that, you have this beautiful table where I ate all of my meals and this L-shaped bench. Directly above, there's actually a projector and this pretty large screen hidden near your fireplace and the chair, so you can have a very serious movie night if you want. You can also easily connect to all of your streaming services via an HDMI cable. I'll now turn our attention in this direction. You can see the stairs that lead to the loft and the second floor, which I'll get to shortly, but also that gorgeous chandelier and the high arch ceilings. I love this angle as well of the kitchen because it really shows off all of those shelves higher up against the wall and all of the beautiful decorations. I think the host did an amazing job. But let's now get a bit closer and enter more into the kitchen because I want to point out a few details. Starting on the left, you have one of those kind of old school and retro looking refrigerators. Next to it, you then have a nice stovetop and your oven setup. And last but not least, you have a very nice modern looking sink there on the right hand side. On the opposite end, you have some of your kitchen essentials and more decorations with a bit of a green theme. Here are your knives. I mean, just look at that presentation. And more bowls and glasses can be found in this area. In this last corner, you also have some more appliances like your coffee maker, toaster, and coffee grounds. Finally, down below is your microwave. I'm now going to take a very short break from the tour. This video is brought to you by Squarespace. Squarespace is the all-in-one platform to grow your business and your online presence. If you saw an earlier video, I actually currently have a Squarespace site of my own that was a little outdated. I've now updated to more reflect my current work. Here are a few screenshots. I'm very happy with this new version.
One of the reasons I was able to easily update my site is because of Squarespace's website builder. They have tons of beautiful website templates to pick from, and you don't need any crazy website design, coding, or technical skills to get the job done. Next, I used a bunch of Squarespace's site building tools, such as full screen editing, automatically responsive designs, and automatic image scaling, which all saved me a lot of time. Last but not least, when you are finally ready to take your website live, Squarespace has a bunch of domain features to help, such as helping you to purchase the domain, seamless domain registration, and you even get a free custom domain for the first year with an annual Squarespace account. So if you're ready to create your own beautiful Squarespace website, head to squarespace.com/MikeWillTravel for a free trial and to then save 10% off your first purchase of a domain or website. Let's now get back to the tour.
Back at the Cliff House now, after our short break, we'll head through this door on the right, which leads into the one bathroom inside of this cabin. You have some eye-catching tiling all along the floor, your toilet on the right, and a modern and clean setup here for your shower. In particular, I also really love the sink inside of this bathroom. It felt very old school and incredibly unique. I've never seen anything like it before. Then there are a bunch of towels and everything else you need on these two shelves. Directly next to the bathroom, we'll come into bedroom number 1 of 2. The key feature is, of course, that beautiful backdrop right behind the bed. The lighting is really, really on point in this room. This is one of my favorite bedrooms that I've seen in quite some time because of that fact. All of the pillows and linens and blankets also match the rest of the aesthetic of this home, and you have 2 matching tables on either side of the bed. Let's now head up these stairs to check out the second floor and the loft area. This space contains what I would consider to be the master bedroom. It's a little more spacious than the last bedroom we just saw. Along this wall, you do have a chair and a desk, and of course your large bed right dead center in the middle of this room. All of your pillows and blankets are quite similar to the downstairs bedroom, and there's an additional chair in this other corner. Last but not least, you have a lot of closet space on the opposite side of this room. And if we lay down in the bed, you get this cool point of view shot. I mean, just look at that ceiling, all of the wood finishing. If we zoom in now, you can see more of the windows and that chandelier. And you get this unique perspective looking back down into the main living room area and the kitchen. Thanks for watching, guys. Check back in soon for another brand new Airbnb tour.